This is Joseph, Assistant Professor of CS Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. So I would like to give a presentation on design and analysis of algorithms. Design and analysis of algorithms. So we know that a train will run on two tracks. Similarly, this subject also will run on two tracks. The first track is design of algorithms. The second track is analysis of algorithms. What's the first track? So design of algorithms. The second track is analysis of algorithms. So throughout this subject, we are going to study about only two topics. So one is the design of algorithm. How to design an algorithm. After designing an algorithm, after developing an algorithm, second step is analysis of algorithms. So analysis of algorithms means that is different concept. That means finding time complexity and space complexity of an algorithm. So it is just overview of the subject. Okay. So what we are going to learn in the subject, only two topics. One is the design of algorithm. Second, analysis of algorithms. So before going to learn design of algorithms and analysis of algorithms, let me explain what is an algorithm. So everyone knows about the algorithm and definition of the algorithm also. So algorithm is a step-by-step procedure to solve a particular problem, or it is a finite set of instructions to perform a particular task. It is very simple definition to remember. Just once again I'll repeat. So algorithm is nothing but it is a step-by-step procedure to solve a particular problem, or it is a finite set of instructions to perform a particular task. Now we'll try to understand what are the properties of algorithms, or characteristics of algorithms, or attributes of algorithms. Okay, so different terminals. So properties of algorithms, or attributes of algorithm, or characteristics of algorithms. Okay, so I call it as a characteristics of algorithm. So characteristics of algorithm. So there are five characteristics of an algorithm. The first one is input. Now second is output. Third one is definiteness. Next, fourth one, finiteness. So fifth one is effectiveness. These are the properties of an algorithm. So input, output, definiteness, finiteness, and effectiveness. Now let us come to the input. Now I'll explain simple example so that you can understand what is the characteristics of this algorithm. Let us take a simple program, printf, SMET. Now let us assume that it is a simple program. Now what is the output of this program? SM is your. So I have written this program in Okay. Now what is the output of this program? SM is here. What is the input to this program? There is no any input. Okay, there is no any input. We are not giving any input to this program. Just this program will display the output of. Okay, that means a program or algorithm may take zero or more number of inputs. I will give one more example so that you can understand clearly. Let us take one more example. Okay. Scanner. So personality, comma address of A, address of B. Let us take int A, comma B, comma C. Okay. So C is equal to A plus B, and printf personality comma C. Okay. Now let us take this program. So this program will take input from the keyboard. What are the inputs here? A value and B value. This program is taking the two values. So those two values will be stored in the address of A and address of B. Okay. And it displays the output. Now this program is not taking any input from the keyboard, and this program is taking the input from the keyboard or user. Okay, now what do you understand? So this program is taking zero number of inputs, whereas this program is taking two input values. Now what do you understand? What's the first characteristic? Input. Okay. Input means what? An algorithm will take zero or more number of inputs. Zero or more number of inputs. Now come to the second one, output. It is the second characteristic of an algorithm. Now what is the output of this algorithm? What is the output of this program? SMS. Now what is the output of this program? Depends on the value. For example, A value is 10 and B value is 20. Okay. So 10 plus 20, 30. 30 will be stored in C. Now it displays the value as 30. Okay. Now, what do you understand? This program is displaying one output. What is the output of this program? SMS only. Okay. Now this is the output of this program. Okay. Now what is the output of this program? If A value is 10 and B value is 20, now this program will display output as 30. Okay. Now what do you understand? So an algorithm will produce at least one output. An algorithm will produce at least one output. Okay. Now come to the third characteristics of an algorithm. Definiteness. So here definiteness means an algorithm contains a set of instructions. No? Each instruction must be defined clearly. Each instruction must be defined. Each instruction should not be ambiguous. Ambiguous means conventional.
Now let me give a simple example so that the characters are clear or definiteness.
Okay. Now let us take add 5 or 6. Add 5 or 6 to x. Okay. Add 5 or 6 to x. Okay. What do you mean? So we are telling the system to add either 5 or 6 to the value of x. That means there is no clarity here. Okay, which value is to be added to the value of x? Either 5 or 6. System will get confusion which value is to be added. So there is no clarity here. So what do you understand here? While defining any instruction, it should be declared clearly.
Or, what is the example? Let's example, a is equal to a plus 5.
A equal to a plus 5. So it is a clear statement. There is no any ambiguity. There is no any confusion here. Just we are telling that add value 5 to the value of A. And the result will be stored in A. Now this
instruction is defined clearly. But this instruction is not defined clearly.
Why? So system will get confusion. Which value is to be added? Either 5 or 6. There is no clarity here. But here there is a clarity. A is equal to A plus 5. That means value 5 will be added to the value of x, value of a. So, okay, that is definiteness. Okay, come to the finiteness. So, finiteness means, so at the beginning of this class, I told you, algorithm means a finite set of instructions. Now, what is finiteness here? Algorithm must be terminated after finite number of steps. Every algorithm must be terminated after finite number of steps. That means it should not contain infinite loop. Okay, so if you write program so that I can understand clearly. So what is finiteness here? Algorithm must be terminated after finite number of steps execution. That is finiteness. Okay, next, what do you mean by effectiveness? It is also very simple to understand. Effectiveness means performing arithmetic operations on floating point values is an effective. Okay, performing arithmetic operations on integers is not effective. So if you want to get exact values, for example 5/3 in C language, 5/3 means how much? 5/3 means, okay,
so here division
operator will produce only coefficient value.
For example 3 1 3 1 3 and 2.
Now 5/3 means it will produce only one. That is in C language, because we have taken integers values, no?
But for example, if you take 5.0 divided by 3.0,
now it will produce exact value. So performing arithmetic operations on integers is not effective. Performing arithmetic operations on float values is effective. Okay, so that's about the various characteristics of an algorithm. Okay, so input, output, definiteness, finiteness, and effectiveness. So I'll conclude that. So input means what do you understand? So which takes an algorithm may take 0 or more number of inputs. Output means an algorithm must produce at least one output. Definiteness means in an algorithm, each and every instruction must be defined clearly. Okay. So finiteness means after certain finite number of steps, algorithm must be terminated successfully. Next, effectiveness. Performing arithmetic operations on integers is not effective. Performing arithmetic operations on floating point values is effective. So that's about the characteristics of an algorithm. Now come to the next point. So next one is different areas to study an algorithm. So that is next topic. Okay. So second topic is what are the various areas to study an algorithm? Areas to study an algorithm. Okay. What are the different areas to study an algorithm? So remember that there are four areas to study an algorithm. Four areas. The first one is how to devise an algorithm. How to devise an algorithm. So this is first area to study an algorithm. The second one is how to validate an algorithm. How to validate an algorithm. Okay. The third one is how to analyze an algorithm. How to analyze an algorithm. How to analyze an algorithm. Now fourth one is how to test a program. How to test a program. Now these are the four areas to study an algorithm. So what are the four areas here? How to devise an algorithm. Second area, how to validate an algorithm. Third one is how to analyze an algorithm. Fourth one is how to test a program. So how to devise an algorithm means device. Device means not a physical device like a keyboard or a mouse. Okay. So here device means develop. How to develop an algorithm or how to write an algorithm or how to create an algorithm. Okay. Now what's our subject name? Design and analysis of algorithm. Now, how to design an algorithm? So remember that. So there are different methods. There are different methods to devise an algorithm. There are different methods to develop an algorithm. There are different methods to write an algorithm. Okay. So in this subject, we are going to learn various methods. Okay, various methods which are used to develop an algorithm. Okay. So first unit, one method, second unit, another method, third unit, one more method, okay. Right, so different methods are there. One is divide and conquer. So divide and conquer. Second method is greedy method. Third one is dynamic programming. Fourth one is backtracking. Fifth one, branch and bound. Okay. So these are the various methods to devise an algorithm. So what are those various methods? Divide and conquer. Second, greedy method. Third one, dynamic programming. Next, fourth one, backtracking. Fifth one is what? Branch and bound. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.